basically what it comes down to is a couple of main issues that have been reiterated over and over. First issue is we need to move. We all know that. We need to really move, and we need to move now. We've always come to conferences, we've talked, and we've had networks and everything, but what makes it real is when we implement it. We've established that Jordan, alhamdulillah, is one of the key areas for global food security. And this, I tell Inovio and the EU and everyone, we need funds to be able to secure these plants. We need to conserve them. The way we're going to conserve them does not rely only on Jordan. It is a collaborative effort through the twinning, as we saw in Work Package 2, and through helping from Inovio, where they will help us actually apply for these funds. We know we can't do it all on our own. And this is why, the very reason we invited all of you here today, because have you not realized that we do it in a qaqa, in a shell, or a clamshell, as RBG and moved on, but we wouldn't be successful. as part of raising our capacity, this should also include things like complementary conservation. A complementary conservation effort, whereby not just doing one seed bank here, we have to go on multi-disciplinary ways of conserving our genetic stock and having duplicates. And that again goes back to collaboration, coordination. And then we have to draw upon the expertise of whoever has it, be it in Birmingham, Kew Garden, or in anywhere else around the world. We need to work together to be able to do best practices, and we can tailor it to specifics of each and every country. For example, as we mentioned earlier, that we have to do specific protocols for the genetic stock. There is not one size fits all in this equation here. Our strategies should also include not only the national level, but the regional. And to be able to make our national strategies or regional ones applicable and actually carry them out, we need the buy-in of the government. The government will not listen to us unless they see the benefit of what we're doing. And the benefit comes when they see that the local communities and the countries are actually being able to utilize this resource. So again, the issue of utilization comes into play. How does conservation become applicable so that the actual thing we're conserving is utilized? Otherwise, they just don't care. It costs money and they don't have that extra money. So this is essential on us to use our communication strategy to make them aware and educate them on the importance of or the value of this resource. And we also mentioned that this is a dynamic process. We can't just do it and stop and say, okay, we've done the checklist, we've done our strategy, and there we go, we've done all that we need to do. It's a continuous process, and hopefully, inshallah, the new checklist will be printed out, and the flora for Jordan will be done. But that doesn't mean we stop there. We have to continue doing this, and that also comes in with more funding and being innovative in our approaches, which hopefully is what Horizon 2020 will help fund, inshallah, for the future. But one leverage that we can use to be able to get the funding is the CBD and the other international treaties, because we've used it actually in RPG. We've used it as a leverage or a pressure point for our countries, and we've told them, you signed this, you ratified it. Now you have to actually carry out your obligations. And we're here ready to provide you with a mechanism to actually implement what you promised to do, inshallah. But this is all good and well, and it won't work unless we involve the local communities, the farmers, and it has to be on the ground, inshallah. And I see and this is not a hard issue. Everyone wants this. When you tell them, your children will starve if we won't do this, everyone will come on board. It is not an issue that used to be considered as a luxury item in the past, where 20 years ago, environment was a luxury. Environment, and they didn't see the importance. People feel climate change today. There's not one person in Jordan who doesn't know the value of climate change. This year, we were so happy we had the big snowstorm at the beginning of the season. We said, oh, everything is fine. There's no climate change. You know, this is fine. We're going to have another really good rainy season. And that's all we got. Until we had to do the rain prayer. And then we got another bout of rain, but that's not enough. So I think from today, everybody realizes we have to move. We have to do it together. We need the funds. And we have to have a multidisciplinary approach to do it. And we'll mobilize the government to see the value of the utilization of these resources to have them support us and let us do what we know best to do, inshallah. Thank you very much. I won't keep you any longer.